Good morning, students. In this lecture 14, we'll discuss working and characteristics of enhancement type MOSFET. As in our previous lecture, we have studied that how the enhancement type MOSFET is constructed and how the channel is formed between source and drain in that case. And we have constructed N-channel enhancement type MOSFET there. So that is why here I have again taken this N-channel enhancement type MOSFET, where we have used this P-type material as a substrate, over which with the help of diffusion, we have diffused these two N-type regions here. Out of these two regions, one will act as source and the other will act as drain. And then a very thin layer of silicon dioxide, which will act as a dielectric between the parallel plate capacitor formed by gate and substrate. So a very thin layer of silicon dioxide, SiO2, it is developed over the surface of this p-type substrate, and then above that thin layer of silicon dioxide, again a metallic contact is developed for the gate terminal. Now here, as you can see, we have total of 4 terminals, but we don't want too many biasing sources. So that is why this source terminal and this substrate terminal, they are internally connected in this way, and both are at same potential, grounded. Because we don't want too many biasing sources, so that is why they have internally connected this source and this substrate terminal, and they are grounded. It means there is no potential difference between this source and substrate. So the potential difference between them is zero. It means they are at same potential. So the potential difference between source and substrate, it is 0 volt. So that is why the biasing voltage, which we were initially denoting as VGSS, now we can also denote this voltage as VGS. Why? Because there is no potential difference between source and substrate. So that is why we can write this VGSS as VGS. Then we will use biasing voltages for the biasing of gate terminal and drain terminal. So here we have discussed in our previous lecture that gate is made more positive with respect to substrate, because this substrate and source, they are at same potential. So what we will do, we will make this gate more positive with respect to this source terminal. So we will apply biasing voltage here, and here we have made gate more positive with respect to source. So because of this biasing voltage, what will happen? Positive charge will start accumulating over the gate terminal, and this will attract negative charge, minority carriers electrons in case of p-type substrate towards it. When this positive charge, it will accumulate over this metallic contact of gate terminal because of this biasing voltage, then it will attract negative charge, that is minority carriers electrons, towards itself. And as this biasing voltage, it is increased further, then it will attract negative immobile ions in case of p-type substrate, which were initially attached to holes, and holes, they are pushed downwards. Holes, they are pushed downwards, and the negative immobile ions which were attached to these holes, they are attracted upwards. So that is why they start drifting towards the surface of this p-type substrate, thereby making this region n-type, which was initially p-type. So therefore, In this way, the channel has been created between the source and the drain. And it will be like this. It will be modified like this. Now the source and the drain, they have connected via this channel, and this channel, it will carry charge carriers from source to drain. Now the charge carriers, they will only move from source to drain if we apply biasing voltage to drain also. If drain is at more positive potential with respect to source, only then the charge carriers will move from source to drain. So now what we will do? We will apply second biasing voltage, which is between this source and this drain terminal. Again, by making drain more positive with respect to source. And this voltage is known as VDS. So now the drain, it is at more positive potential than source. So it will attract negative charge carriers, that is electrons. So in this way, the drain current will flow through this enhancement type MOSFET via this channel. Now our next aim is to find the potential difference between these two points. We know about the potential difference between gate and the source, which is VGS. But we don't know about the potential difference between this gate terminal and this drain terminal. So we need to find the potential difference between this gate and drain. So how we can calculate that? At this gate terminal, what will be the potential? Suppose it is VG. And suppose the potential at this drain terminal, it is VD. So we have to calculate VG minus VD. So for that, use Kirchhoff's voltage law in this loop, because current ID, it will flow in this direction. So use Kirchhoff's voltage law in this loop. So apply KVL to find VGD. It will be VG, then this VG is positive. And again we have positive, so signs are not alternate, so we'll have minus VGS. Then we have this biasing voltage VDS. This was positive, this end was positive, and this is negative, so signs are alternate. So here we will have plus VDS. Then again plus VD, so signs are not alternate, so again minus VD, it is equal to zero. We have to calculate the potential difference between gate and drain. So we have to calculate VG minus VD. So what will be the value of VG minus VD here? It will be VG minus VD. It is equal to VGS minus VDS. And this VG minus VD, you can write it as VGD. It is the potential difference between gate and drain. Now we'll discuss three cases further. Out of which first case is when VDS is equal to 0 volt. So we have just calculated the potential difference between gate and drain, which comes out to be VGS minus VDS. So if VDS is 0, this implies the potential difference between gate and drain, it is equal to the potential difference between gate and source. What does this implies? VGD is equal to VGS, means the potential difference between these two points, it is VGS, and the potential difference between these two points, it is VGD, and both are equal in the first case when VDS is 0. So when the potential difference between these two points and these two points, it is same, then what will happen? Then the width of this depletion layer, it will be uniform throughout the channel. or you can say that width of channel will be uniform from this end to this end. From source to drain, the width of channel will be uniform and the width of depletion layer will be uniform in the case when the gate and source and gate and drain, they have same potential difference. So this means the width of depletion layer, the width of depletion layer is uniform, or the width of channel is uniform. Now, in the previous lecture, we have also discussed about gate threshold voltage, that is VT. What was this gate threshold voltage? It was the minimum voltage required at the gate terminal to produce inversion, to convert that P-type portion of that substrate into N-type channel. So, this VGS, it must be greater than VT, only then the current will flow through the channel. So this implies that this excess voltage which will be equal to VGS minus VT, it will be responsible for the flow of drain current. Higher is the value of excess voltage, higher will be the width of the channel and higher will be the drain current. Lesser is the value of excess voltage, lesser will be the width of the channel and lesser will be the value of drain current. So here we have, higher is the value of VGS, higher will be the excess voltage, then higher will be the channel width and higher will be the drain current. Now we'll discuss case 2, where we have made this VDS greater than 0 volt, just greater than 0 volt. In that case, what will be the value of VGD? It is VG minus VD and it is equal to VGS minus VDS. Here you can see we have increased this VDS from 0 volt to some positive value. So it means this VDS, it has increased. This VDS has increased. What does this mean? It means VGS minus some positive value. So this VGD, it will decrease. And decrease in VGD means, this implies VG minus VD, it is decreasing. And it will decrease only if this VD, it is becoming more positive. So this implies VD is becoming more positive. This implies drain is more positive. So when VDS is increased from 0 volt to some positive value, drain will become more positive and the potential difference between gate and drain terminal, it will decrease. And now the potential difference between gate and source terminal is greater than the potential difference between this gate and drain terminal. So that is why the width of depletion layer, it will increase as we move from gate to drain. So width of depletion layer will no longer be uniform will no longer be uniform and the width of depletion layer will increase from gate to drain. Why? Because potential difference between gate to drain has decreased. So this implies channel width will decrease from gate to drain. So here you can see when this VDS, it has made positive greater than 0 volt, then the potential difference between these two points, it has decreased. Now the potential difference between gate and drain, it is smaller than the potential difference between gate and source. So the depletion layer, it will increase on this side. Whole of this region, it will be converted into depletion region. And the channel width is also not uniform. Channel width will decrease as you move from gate to drain. So in this way, when VDS is made positive, then drain becomes positive. And when drain becomes positive, you can say that this side, it will become more reverse biased than the source side. So that is why depletion layer on this side, its width increases and the channel width decreases. And the third case is when VDS, the drain source voltage, biasing voltage, it is increased further. When you keep on increasing this VDS, and at one time, this VDS, it will be equal to the excess voltage. This VDS, it will be equal to the excess voltage. And what is the excess voltage? It is the difference between gate source voltage and threshold voltage. So at that time, what will be the value of VGD? Or you can say that potential difference between gate and drain. What is the potential difference between gate and drain? It is VGS minus VDS. So when this VDS, it becomes equal to VGS minus T, put this value here, what you will get? It will be VGS minus VGS plus VT. So VGS and minus VGS, it will be cancelled out. So here, the potential difference between gate and drain terminal, it will be just equal to the threshold voltage. It means the width of depletion layer, it will increase further. The width of depletion layer, this VGD, it must be greater than VT for large value of channel width and for small value of the width of depletion layer. But here this VGD, it is just equal to VT. It means the width of depletion layer will increase and the channel width will decrease. It will not become zero because the drain current, it is not zero in case of output characteristics of this MOSFET or junction field effect transistor. So the width of depletion layer, it will increase to a large extent, and it is known as pinch off. And channel width near the drain side, it will be very small. So after this, when you will increase this VDS above this value, then the drain current, it becomes constant. And that is why this value is known as VDS saturation. So after pinch off, when you will further increase this VDS, then the drain current, it remains constant through the MOSFET. So these are the three cases. Now we'll discuss output and transfer characteristics in case of enhancement MOSFET. But before that, one more thing here, when this VDS, it is equal to VGS minus VT, so in that case the width of depletion layer, it will increase further near the drain side, and the channel width, it has decreased to a large extent. And when you will increase this VDS above that value, VGS minus VT, then the value of drain current, it remains constant. So this is known as pinch off condition, and that value of VDS, it is known as VDS saturation. So first of all, we'll draw the output characteristic curve for n-channel enhancement MOSFET. So these are the curves between the drain current and the drain source voltage at some fixed values of gate source voltage. And as you know that in case of n-channel enhancement MOSFET, VGS is always made more positive. VGS is positive here. And as you will increase the value of VGS, more and more negative charge, it will be drifted towards the upper surface of the substrate. It means more will be the channel width and more will be the drain current as you will increase the VDS. So here, suppose here the value of VGS was initially plus 1 volt, and in this, when you will increase the value of VGS from plus 2, then here VGS, suppose it is plus 3, and here suppose VGS it is plus 5, and here suppose VGS it is equal to plus 6. So in this way, when we have increased this VGS in a positive voltage, we have applied positive voltage to the gate terminal with respect to source. So in this way, the gate terminal is becoming more and more positive. So more and more positive charge will accumulate over the gate terminal, which will attract more and more negative charge carriers near the surface of the substrate. So the channel will be formed and the current will start flowing from source to drain when you will apply biasing voltage across source and drain. So when we will increase this source drain source voltage, and by increasing this VGS, the drain current will increase because channel width is increasing by increasing the value of VGS on a positive side. So this is all about output characteristics. Now we'll draw the transfer characteristic curve. Transfer characteristic curve is the variation of output current drain current with the variation in control voltage input voltage, that is gate source voltage, at some constant value of output voltage, which is drain source voltage. So this transfer characteristic curve, it is different from the curve which is given in your moderns book. Why? Because there they have discussed p-channel enhancement MOSFET, and here we have discussed n-channel enhancement MOSFET. In case of p-channel enhancement MOSFET, gate is made more negative with respect to substrate. So that is why in that case, in the case of p-channel enhancement MOSFET, this VGS, it will be negative here. But here this VGS, in case of n-channel enhancement MOSFET, this VGS is positive. We have made this VGS more positive with respect to source. We have made gate terminal more positive in this case with respect to source. Then the channel and channel will be formed between source and drain. So here you can see VDS will have some greater than zero fixed value. And when you will increase this VGS, we know that with increase in VGS, channel width is increasing, means drain current will increase. So, and we know that the relation between ID and VGS is parabolic. So this curve, it will be like this. Means as you will increase this VGS, this drain current will increase. So this is all about the construction, working and characteristics of N-channel enhancement MOSFET.